Alright, somebody wanted me to do a review on my AR-15 rifle. So here it is. This is my DPMS AR-15 rifle. It's chambered in 223 or 5.56 for you military people. It comes with a 16-inch barrel with an A2 flashfighter on it. Your barrel is a chrome molly, a 6-groove, right-handed, 1x9 twist. The finish on this is a hard coat anodized in Teflon black. It comes with a A1 upper on it and a 6-position collapsible stock. And you should also get two 30-round magazines with it. Alright, pros about this. Unlike most AR-15 platforms, DPMS makes some of the cheapest AR-15 platforms out there. And they're very good quality too. It's a AR-15, so it has great sights. When you shoot more like an AK, you get to feel that you got like a more of an assault rifle type shooting. But when you're shooting something like an AR, it distinctly feels more like a rifle, and that translates into better accuracy. The manageable recoil is great on this. When you're shooting something like an AK, you have this large piston that moves up and down, and the bolt is actually offset on the firearm. The AR-15 is the exact opposite. The bolt is exactly center with the firearm. It's a small bolt. There's no large piston. It's only gas driven. So the manageable recoil on this is great. You can really control this. I mean, even if you had a full auto version, it's still very good controllability. Customization. You can customize AR platforms very easily. Not really cheap, but very easily. There's many things you can do. As you can see on mine, I customized it. I mean, a lot of this stuff ain't original. Alright, cons about this rifle. When you first get it, it's hard to tell with my particular setup, but when you first get it, you get everything's pretty simple with stock. You get a like Glacier handguard, it's very simple, it's polymer. You get a 6-position stock, but it's very simple, it's a little bit smaller. But you still get everything you need, you know. You still get your forward assist, you know, your shell deflector, your charging handle. You still get everything you need for a good platform rifle. Cons on the AR-15 rifles, the same thing that makes them so accurate is the same thing that kind of takes away for their reliability, and that is, instead of like an AK, it has a large bolt that stops the gases from coming down into the chamber. The AR-15 is exactly opposite. The gases are actually siphoned down into the chamber until about a piston right about here, and this creates a lot of the gases going into the chamber and, you know, creates a problem for some people. Personally, I've only had one jam out of probably 50,000 rounds. But I also, you know, maintain my firearms rigorously. If you pull out your magazine after you fired about 20 rounds out of a 30-round magazine, you'll find that a lot of the rounds will have soot on them, and that's because of the gas being pushed down there. Another thing about it is, same thing that makes it so accurate at long range, the same thing that takes away from you from close range. Because of the small peep sight, even though they have a flip peep sight for closer ranges, it's still hard to get, you know, a good, like, a 40-yard target, 50-yard target, so it's hard to shoot it accurately fast because you're so close into the bead itself that you lose your sight picture every time. But, you know, it's not bad. Alright, modifications for this. There's many things you can do to modifications on AR-15 type style rifles. It's one of the great things about them. There's a lot of aftermarkets out there and you can pretty much pimp it out to whatever you please. As you can see on this, I got this large bulbous thing on here all of a sudden. I didn't want to show you this right away because it don't come with the firearm itself, and I want to give you the right impression. This is my personal setup for competition shooting. I have a scope with a side-mounted red dot. And the scope allows me to reach out to further targets, and when I come in close, all you gotta do is turn, and that allows me to access closer targets. I got another modification on here is it's a quad pinnacle rail forearm. It basically gives you a pinnacle rail on four sides of the firearm itself. I also got a pistol grip, vertical grip here with a flashlight on it, tactical type shooting. It's always good to have a flashlight on the rifle, if you ask me. I got pistol grip, Samco grips here, a little more comfortable ergonomically. I also got a Samco AR-15 butt stock on here also, you know. But other than that, pretty much simple, you know. I didn't do nothing to my trigger. I didn't, you know, mag well extension or nothing like that. It's relatively stock still. Alright, I'm going to do a function test also on this. I normally don't do function tests in my review videos because it's an AR-15 platform and there's a lot of naysayers out there. I'm going to do a function test, and in this test you will see me hitting the bolt release button here. Sometimes that bolt release gets, if you hit it real hard, a lot of AR-15 platforms, it'll stop the bolt from locking back. You'll also see me pounding on the bottom of the magazine to try to force it into the chamber itself. A lot of magazines, if an AR-15 rifles, if you set them on the ground, you're shooting, you'll get jammed this way. First, I've never had it in this. But I'm going to do these tests, and I'm going to do fast fire also. I'm going to use two types of ammo on this also. I'm going to use a Wolf 55 grain and a Winchester 55 grain. Relatively cheap. If you get a DPMS one, it's more cheaper than most ARs you're going to look up out there. Really customizable, easy to shoot, extremely accurate. Adjustable butt stock here, so you can adjust your length of pull. Cons about it, you know, of course, it's not extremely reliable. It does get dirty, it does jam sometimes. If you get one, you know, I think you should maintain it rigorously to keep it up to par. Of course, I think that with all firearms, but more importantly with an AR. If you want something to beat the shit out of and throw away, and, you know, just throw it in the back when you're done, get an AK. But if you want something that shoots extremely accurate and a lot faster and more precision-wise, you know, get an AR. That's mostly things about it.